Madam President. Doesn't that sound great? Madam President. Madam Toastmaster, fellow Toastmasters. Phone rings at 3 a.m. You awake from a sound sleep. Immediately, you think the worst. In my case, a loved one was rushed by ambulance to the hospital for heart distress again. I'm not here to inform you that cardiovascular disease kills 1 in 3 Americans every year and costs over $1 billion annually. I am here because I want to stop being afraid of what can go wrong and start being excited about what you can do that's right. Before I get into that, it bothers me when I'm so lazy I can't get off of the couch. When I have little respect for sleep and I just want one more game on my iPad. Or the dinner dishes can wait until tomorrow. Isn't that so much fun to wake up to in the morning? I am a very naturally lazy person. What's going right in my life is my Fitbit. I never thought I would be so addicted to such a small piece of electronics. It has brought me down such a happier, healthier path. My kids now want one because they see how energized I am. Have you heard the story about the daughter who bought her father a Fitbit? She was very concerned about his health and he was having heart problems, so she bought him a Fitbit. Very shortly afterwards, she went online, she checked his stats, she realized he was having a heart attack. The Fitbit saved his life. So I can't believe such a little piece of software, it took so long to be invented. My Fitbit is the very first thing I put on in the morning, and it's the last thing I take off at night. I have to take it off at night or I can't sleep. But I'm so pumped in the morning when I put that thing on, and I cannot wait to get started and get pumped and get those steps in. I try to go for 10,000 steps a day. My goal is 17,000 steps in one day, which is a little over, it's about almost 6 miles, between 5 and 6 miles. It's also encouraged me to take breaks throughout the day with my coworkers and just take a quick lap around the building. It's encouraged me to take the stairs rather than the elevator. Again, I'm a naturally lazy person. Once I reach 10,000 steps, my Fitbit gives me a little vibration and a little kind of fireworks in my Fitbit. That's exciting. And it kind of catches me off guard, puts a little smile on my face. Any opportunity that you can give yourself congratulations throughout the day, everybody needs that. So I do have to be mindful though, because your Fitbit recognizes this as a stride. So if you're holding your drink in your hand, or if you're holding your computer on your person and you're walking, Fitbit's not recognizing that. So when you walk in 97 degree heat over to Round Rock 5 from Round Rock 2 and you have your computer in hand, I feel like I'm been gypped. But anyway, granted, walking and running is very time consuming and it can be very lonely. If you do have friends that have a Fitbit, it can recognize your Facebook profile and you can put those friends, you can select those friends in your little community within your Fitbit. And it's a very friendly competition. It's been very important to me because I can reach out to my friends, they can reach out to me, and we can celebrate each other's successes as to who gets the 10,000 steps first. So, they know my challenges, I know I can count on them for support, and I will certainly offer them a gold star. Let's see, it also calculates your beats per minute, so it recognizes when you do exercise. So how many of you have conversations with the 22-year-old Well Adele coaches? Have you ever talked to the same person twice? I never have. What does a 22-year-old know about a 48-year-old woman with 3 children? It's really hard to have that relationship and conversation with. So I tell them, I've synced my Fitbit up to the Well Adele portal. They can get all of their information from there. I was also told that there is a scale that is, you can electronically sync
to the Well Adele, so you don't even have to have a conversation with them again. I'm looking forward to buying the scale. So, I recognize I'm never going to be a petite size 2, though I do want to tell you, I did finally move to almost the very last notch in my Fitbit. That's really important to me. So, it does calculate your meals if you want to put in your meals, and it'll calculate your calories you can put in your meals and it'll calculate how many calories that you've burned off. My Fitbit, I respond to numbers, and numbers do not lie. It's a solid way for me to become accountable. I'm proud of the fact that I have cheated on the word doubt. I've broke up with the word later. I've stopped my relationship with a Diet Coke. As somebody who's drank Diet Coke since I was 12 years old, I'm proud of that. It's been a very emotional journey. I'm now engaged with the sunshine in my heart, where I am so energized when I wake up in the morning. I know that I'm doing my body good. And I don't want anybody to have that conversation with my children that I have to go to the hospital by ambulance. So, here's to my future with my Fitbit. Thank you. By the way, it will also tell you what time it is.